Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. The buzzer told the monkey, you are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free. The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, your story's so touching, sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Breathe, breathe. You are choking me, release your hold, then I will set you free. The monkey looked the buzzard right dead in the eye and said, your story's so touching, it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Empire Central Radio, ECNR. This is where the crooners hang their hats.
Oh, throw him out the window, he can't stay. How did he get in here? Anyway, what do we want with him around the place? The pessimistic caricature, the crab apple face. When he hears a joke, he always cries. When there's any fun, darn near dies. What do you say we laugh at this bad case? The pessimistic caricature, the crab apple face. He's never welcome anywhere he goes. Let him stay where he belongs. In a book of Edgar Allan Poe, why don't we lose him? Wrap him in a blanket, carefully.
Hey, Hey, mission accomplished. How'd it go?
Yeah, piece of cake. Except for the fact that the car belonged to a bunch of moolies who immediately tried to kill me right after you left.
Probably the bombers. Hunters, their neighborhood. Guys like that, you don't have to worry about them. They just hang out on the street, talk shit, steal shit, and smoke dope. Let's see what we got here.
Oh, nice. No stains. Clean.
The lowlife get the money for this. Probably stole it himself. It's nice, though. How much did I say I'd give you for it again?
600.
Oh, I like your buddy, Joe. Here's your 400 bucks. Stop by again, okay? We can do some more business.
Yeah, you bet, Mike.
I see you, Mike. I'll stop by again real soon.
All
Me
right,
too.
Boys. I'll see you later.
Here's your 300 bananas. I'm taking my cut as the middleman. Next time, you're on your own.
All right. Thanks, Joe.
All right, let's go home. I'm exhausted.
By a country road, wild roses grow that need my special care. So I haven't time to be a millionaire. And a cheerful brook on a mountainside is sad when I'm not there. So I haven't time to be a millionaire. And a friendly gang of robins are pleased when I forget. I'm the second tenor.
We should take the highway, Vito. All right, you pulled off that job without fucking it up. Nice going.
Yeah, but I almost got my ass kicked. I didn't live through the war just to die in Sand Island.
Hey, that's all part of the deal, pal. Take it or leave it. Besides, it ain't like you're qualified for anything else.
I guess you're right.
Don't worry about it. It's all gonna be a piece of cake.
So, what's the story with Bruski?
Mike's a good guy to know. He's a little grouchy, but he's always got a scam going. He deals with stolen cars mostly. Spent some time inside a while back. I heard he used to stick up gas stations back in the day.
You gonna make him pay the cleaning bill for your jacket?
Nah, I'll let that one slide. I do a lot of business with the guy. Plus, he's got one hell of a temper. One time, we was at the track, and some mick spilled a beer on his wind ticket. Mike beat the shit out of him till he went blind in one eye. Lousy 10 bucks. You believe that shit?
Sounds like kind of a scumbag.
Hey, you just got an out of hand to these people. And Mike's a pussycat compared to some of the guys I met since you shipped out. You'll see.
Come on, let's go already!
If I wish so well, it wouldn't be quite fair.
Be quite fair. But I haven't found
full of dreams. It's my universe, even with an empty purse, 'cause I've got pockets full of dreams. take the wealth on Wall Street for a road where nature trots. And I calculate that I am worth my weight in gold and rust. Lucky, lucky me, I can live in luxury, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams.
Safe place to park around here. I don't want to leave this thing out in the street.
Yeah, that's why you're parking your car next to mine in the garage. The streets are full of criminals these days.
Yeah, the neighborhood ain't what it used to be, huh?
Oh, I'm no millionaire, but I'm not the type to care, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. It's my universe, teeming with an empty purse, 'cause I've got a pocket full of dreams. I would take a wealth of Wall Street for a road where nature thrives, and I calculate that I'm worth of my way.
If you're hungry, there's some food in the refrigerator. You hungry, Vito? Take whatever you want from the fridge.
Joe's pleasure, pal. It's Vito speaking.
Vito, why didn't you come home last night? I was worried sick.
Mama? I didn't know you had Joe's number. And whose phone is this?
So have you spoken to Mr. Pappalardo? Find yourself a job?
Yeah, he told me to come by and see him today. Hopefully he's got some work for me.
Okay, Vito. Good luck, mio bambino.
All right, bye, Mama.
Oh, hi there.
If you don't turn that crap down, I'm gonna call the cops!
You're in my way.
A monkey for a ride in the air. The monkey thought that everything was on the square. The buzzard tried to throw the monkey off of his back, but the monkey grabbed his neck and said, "Now listen, Jack. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. Ain't no use in diving. What's the use of diving? Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top. The buzzer told the monkey, you are choking me. Release your hold and I will set you free." The monkey looked the buzzer right dead in the eye and said, "Your story's so touching, it sounds just like a lie. Straighten up and fly right. Straighten up and stay right. Straighten up and fly right. Cool down, Papa, don't you blow your top.
Thank you.
The door. It's windy. What do you want?
I'm looking for a Mr. Papalotto.
Oh, yeah? Why?
My name's Vito Scaletta. My old man used to work for him, and I'm looking for a job, so I came here.
Well, you're in the right spot, sonny boy. Federico Papalotto at your service. You can call me Derek. I think I remember your dad. Good guy, but drank like a fish. What's he up to these days?
He's dead.
Oh, well, we all gotta go sometime. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
So you need a job, huh? Well, you're in luck. We just got a new shipment to unload. Steve will show you around. Now scram, my steak's getting cold.
Follow me. Load this pile of crates onto that truck. When you're done, you get $10. If something gets lost or broken, you get nothing. Start now and don't take all day.
This is gonna be a lot of fun. Who the fuck wants to move boxes around all goddamn day? All this for 10 lousy bucks? You gotta be kidding me. Oh, how can these guys stand this? I'm doing this for 5 fucking minutes, I already hate it. You know what? I don't need this chicken shit money.
Hey, you done?
Yeah, I'm done. And you can keep the $10. When I said I needed a job, I didn't mean slave labor.
Whatever. Get the fuck out of here, then. Don't show your face around here again.
Yeah, don't worry. I can make 100 times more working for Barbaro Incorporated.
Wait, you said Barbaro? Joe Barbaro?
Yeah, so what?
Shit. Nobody who works with Joe would carry crates for $10. What the hell are you doing? Come with me. What now? Well, this one don't like manual labor.
What the fuck?
Said he works with Joe Barbaro.
Bullshit. Who wanna load crates if he works with Joe? You'll have to explain this one to me, sonny boy. What's your story?
My mother wanted me to come talk to you about an honest job, but I need some real money, so this ain't gonna cut it.
Them women, they're all the same. Right, Steve?
Sure, Derek.
She doesn't want you hanging around with Joe, right? My mother was the same way. Look what become of me. Union boss. I got the whole fucking waterfront under my thumb. So how's Joe?
Pretty good, I guess.
How'd you meet up with him?
Oh, we go way back to the old neighborhood. I just come back from overseas and he's putting me up until I can get back on my feet.
Listen, you gotta understand, a person in my position's gotta be careful.
Certainly.
So you won't mind if I give Joe a call, right?
Nah, go ahead.
Now, where'd I put his number? Hey, here it is. He might not be home. That wouldn't be good. Hi, Joe. Hey, this is Derek. Listen, I got this guy here. What'd you say your name was?
Vito.
Vito. He's looking for a job. He says he's a friend of yours. A good friend. I just wanted to check with you first. Uh-huh. Sure, war hero and all that shit. All right, thanks then. I'll talk to you later. Sorry, pal, I had to check you out. Joe says you just come back from Italy. You must be able to handle yourself. You want to make a little more money, I got just the thing. The guys here at the port are supposed to pay a monthly fee to the barber, but half of them never cough it up. I need someone to give them a little nudge. $10 a man.
What if they don't need a haircut?
Well, then you'll have to convince them otherwise.
I see. What if somebody makes a fuss?
Then you kick the shit out of them.
Well, let's say you teach them a lesson that doesn't require that they miss work. You got it? Which is why Steve ain't doing the job. Right, Steve?
Right, boss.
Collect at least $150, I give you 50. Just for walking around, taking in the sea air and meeting new people. Easy fucking money, eh? What do you say?
Yeah, hey, it's better than lugging crates around.
All right, then. Get going.
I'm here to collect the fee for the barber.
And what kind of game you playing here?
The kind where you pay what you owe when you don't get hurt. You got a problem with that?
I got a problem with you. Now get out of here before I kick your ass.
Ooh!
Here's your fucking money.
Yeah, glad you decided to reconsider. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Yeah. I must have forgot or something.
Next time, try to pay on time, okay? Thanks. Hey, Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Sure, here it is. I don't want no problems.
Don't leave it until the last minute next time. Hey, pal. Derek needs you to pay the fee for the barber.
Look, asshole. I'm not in the mood. Why don't you get out of my face before you get hurt?
No can do, pal. Derek wants his money.
Derek can kiss my ass. What's that fat fuck gonna do? Have me killed?
Hey, you said it, not me.
Why don't you give it a try then, asshole?
Out of him! Come on, you little baby!
Yeah. Teach him a fucking lesson!
Kick his ass!
Okay. Anybody else? Got a fucking problem with paying for the fucking barber?
Here's the money, boss man.
Good job. Here's your share. I watched you take care of Bill. You were good. Steve damn near got his ass kicked when he tried that. Right, Steve?
Right, Derek.
Here's a bonus for sorting him out.
Thanks.
The guy's been a real fucking pain.
Now get out of here, kid. I gotta be getting back to business. Say hello to your mother for me. Tell her you got yourself a job as my new assistant.
Yeah, will do. I'll see you later.
Vito, I almost forgot. Joe called. He wants you should meet him at Freddy's.
For a deadly reprisal during Operation Bolton. Just over a month ago, German Luftwaffe planes surged in early morning to the surprise of Allied forces in France, Belgium, and Holland. 200 Allied aircraft were destroyed, and another 150 were damaged before Allied fighter pilots took to the skies to exact swift retribution. When the smoke cleared, almost 300 of the Kaiser's flying brigade were destroyed, with an estimated 200 German pilots killed, 20 of whom were formation leaders. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harris. We'll be right back.
steady till she gets ready. That chick's too young to fry. Take her back in the barnyard, then let her go, just turn her loose. Stop your crying, that chick's too young to fry.
Are you looking to buy a gun, or you just need some ammo? I loaded these myself in the back. Here you go. Bye-bye. Come back.
And greatest in jazz and blues. Keep it locked to this station, EDLT, Delta Radio, Empire Bay.
Have a banana, Anna. Try the salami, Tommy. You whip the gravy, baby. Try a tomato, plate too. Here's cacciatore, Dory. Taste the bologna, Tony. Everybody eats when they come to my house. I fix your favorite dishes, hoping this good food fills ya. Work my hands to the bone in the kitchen alone. You better eat if it kills.
Hello. How can I help you today? Wow, it fits you perfect. Take care and come again.
Chops!
17th, Warsaw, Poland. Polish flags fly high in celebration as the Polish people have now been liberated from the tyrannical grip of the invading Nazi forces. Soviet troops marched into the capital city and battled fierce resistance to expel the Germans from Polish soil, delivering yet another crushing blow to the already crumbling German forces. There are reports of heavy casualties on both sides of the conflict. For Press Radio News, I'm Lowell Harrett.
Hey, where the hell you been?
I came right over as soon as you called. What's going on?
You remember the wise guys we used to see when we was kids?
Yeah, why?
The guy we're meeting here is one of them. His name's Henry Tomasino. I think he's got something big for us.
Yeah, no shit.
Yeah. We're done with the small-time jobs. It's time to make some real shuttle. Here, he's coming. Don't say nothing stupid.
Hey, Henry, how are you?
Hiya, Joe. This the guy?
Yeah, this is Vito, an old friend of mine.
Good to meet you, Henry.
You vouch for him?
Absolutely, Henry. Trust him with my life.
Okay, listen. I got a job for you. The money's good. I need gas stamps. They're worth a fortune now because of the gas shortage.
Where can we get them?
In the Office of Price Administration.
That's a federal government agency. Isn't that a little risky?
What? Too much for you?
No. Just trying to think of how we can pull it off.
It can't be that hard. The stamps are kept in the safe at night, but the keys are probably around here somewhere.
You got somebody inside?
Yeah, one of our guys. His sister works there.
Can she help us out?
Ask her yourself. Her name's Maria Agnello. Here's the address. Tell her I say it.
All right, what about the safe? What if the keys aren't there?
That's your problem.
But what's the job pay?
I'll give you $600 for 10,000 gallons worth of stamps.
Okay, we're in.
No, I need Vito to do this alone. I got another job for you, Joe. So? What do you say, Vito?
Yeah, sure.
Hey, and don't forget to take a piece with you. You never know what's gonna happen. Better to be safe than sorry. I got beef.
Wait. This isn't some liquor store stick-up. I want this to be a clean job. If you kill anybody, your cut drops to a third. Gabish?
Yeah, I got it. No problem.
Okay, when you're done, you come back in, we'll settle up.
All right, I'll see
you. Good luck, Vito.
Yeah, so long, buddy.
RCO5 radio from
Come
Empire
in, young
Electronics.
Man. Come.
RCO5 radio? Yes, sir. The RCO5 is the most superb listening experience around. It has monophonotronic sound delivery and tuning, so you and the family will...
Mr. Percy, have mercy on me. Mercy.
Yeah, can I help you?
Yeah, hello, ma'am. Henry Tomasino sent me. He said you might be able to help me with a little problem down at the Office of Price Administration.
Yeah, I heard about that. What do you need from me?
I need to get in there tonight.
All right, tell you what. My sister's in the hospital right now. If you give me a lift over there, I'll tell you everything you need to know. It's right across the street from the OPA, so it ain't like you're gonna be going out of your way.
Sure, no problem.
Okay, let's go. And take it easy behind the wheel, all right? I seen the way you kids drive these days. All right, kid. The place is locked up pretty tight at night, so you gotta get in through the back.
They keep the back door open at night?
No, but the basement window usually is, so that's how you can get in. You're looking for the safe, right?
Yeah, how'd you know?
Lucky guess. It's on the top floor. So's the director's office. That's where the keys are.
Okay. So I go in through a window around the back, then head upstairs to the director's office, right?
Right. And be careful, there's guards in there at night. Don't let them see you. All right, kid. Drop me at the hospital right here. The office is across the street. Okay, thanks for the ride, kid.
Thanks, Maria. I'll see you.
that pipe down while I finish my puzzle.
Raspberries. I'm gonna go make the rounds.
Good riddance to you.
Any plans for the weekend?
Yeah, gonna relax and watch me some television.
You bought a television?
I sure did.
Man, those things cost as much as a car. How the hell have you afford it?
Mary's Uncle Lou passed away a few months back, left us some cash.
And you bought yourself a television with it?
That's what I did. You ought to see this thing. 7-inch black and white screen get...
Wow, sounds fascinating.
Okay, this is the director's office. This is where the key should be. All right, here's the key. Now I gotta get to the safe. Thank you.
Bay Police Department. We have you surrounded. Come out with your hands up. If you do not surrender immediately, we will open fire.
Thank you.